While the two reports have similar findings, the major difference is the cause of death. The Pima County Medical Examiner's Office conducted the autopsy on 27-year-old Ingram Lopez the day after he died, after being restrained by three Tucson police officers. The Pima County Office of the Medical Examiner reported, the cause of death is ascribed to sudden cardiac arrest in the setting of acute cocaine intoxication and physical restraint with cardiac left ventricular hypertrophy as a significant contributing condition. The News 4 Tucson investigators learned that as part of the investigation into Ingram Lopez's death, the pathologist and several witnesses viewed the Tucson police body cam footage from the night of the incident when former officer Samuel Rutledge, Ryan Starbuck, and Jonathan Jackson responded to Ingram Lopez's grandmother's house and found him naked and acting delusional. The independent autopsy was conducted 3 days after Ingram Lopez's death. It was performed in Mesa by Dr. Philip Keene, who formerly worked as the medical examiner for Maricopa and Yavapai counties. He also reviewed the body cam footage and came up with a different cause of death. His death is most consistent with asphyxia due to compromised airway, which is best explained by a face-down position restricting his breathing. While there were only small abrasions on his left back and flank, he was in a face-down position with his wrists cupped, and this would potentially further compromise his breathing. We contacted the medical examiner's office to get their reaction to the second autopsy. They replied in an email, beyond the release of the report, we are not offering public comment pending anticipated future litigation surrounding this death. The county attorney's office told us they will be looking at the second autopsy and talking to the medical examiner's office about it. They will also look at any additional evidence that's relevant to the inquiry. And that's what the family is hoping for.
True investigation into looking at those actions. That indifference demonstrated by the officers is very concerning and should be very concerning to the whole Tucson community.
We'll keep you posted. Investigating for you, Lupita Murillo, News for Tucson.